You know, we all have one sitting there right in our mouths. It's called a sweet tooth, right? I know I've got one, but there are ways to satisfy that sweet tooth in a healthy way. So in this video, I want to talk about it. Hey, what's going on, everybody? I am Tony Jacobson, the author of Disable Your Disability and certified personal trainer. And at the heart of it, I'm just a dude with a disability who learned how to embrace it to live a healthy, high-powered, happy life. And now I'm here to help you do the same. So if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. And if you're already a subscriber, well, you get that high five. Okay, look, first of all, we are programmed to want sweets. Our bodies and our brains are programmed to want sweets because when we eat sweets, it releases serotonin in our brains, which makes us feel good. So just know that it's a natural thing if you've got a sweet tooth, okay? There's nothing wrong with it. The problem comes when we want to satisfy that sweet tooth and then we just indulge in candy too much and in sweets, chocolate, right? Oh, I love chocolate too, trust me. Here's some ways to satisfy that sweet tooth, but in a healthy way. The first thing you wanna do is reach for a healthy alternative. You can do fruits or dried fruits. You could do granola. You could even do dark chocolate. Yes, it's okay to actually eat that chocolate, but you just wanna do it in moderation and you wanna get some dark chocolate. And when you're eating dark chocolate, look for the percentage on the package because the higher the percentage, the less sugar that chocolate's gonna have. So the next thing you can do is head off hunger at the pass. What happens in our bodies is our blood sugar will start to go down as we start to get hungry, right? So what our body is saying is it's starting to crave sugars. So what you wanna do is try and eat something before you're actually hungry. A good way to do this is to actually schedule your meals. You know, having meals throughout the day as opposed to just three big meals is a good way to do it. Keeps your blood sugar regulated throughout the day and gives you consistent energy throughout the day as well. The next thing you can do is distract yourself. Look, if these cravings are coming on and you're sitting in your house, like get out of your house. Go for a walk, go get some fresh air, go visit a friend, get on the phone, make some phone calls, go do a workout. Do whatever you can to get away from the kitchen at that point. Whatever you do, don't walk down to a 7-Eleven or the local liquor store because you'll end up getting some sweets there. Another important step in this process is really learning more about sugars in foods. Most foods have some sort of sugar in them, so you want to learn more about the foods you're eating and how much sugar is actually in these foods. A good way to start learning about this is to track your food. I use MyFitnessPal. There's other apps out there that will help you, that will show you the nutritional information once you input the foods that you're eating, and it'll show you how much sugar is in each of these foods. So it's just a great way to start wrapping your head around how much sugar is actually in the foods that we eat. The last thing I want to say is try to avoid these sugar alternatives. Sugar alternatives are just processed. Some of them have chemicals in them and they're just going to trigger your brain to want more sugar. And that's just going to defeat the purpose. So I'm going to ask you, do you struggle with eating sugar? Do you have a serious sweet tooth? Comment below and let me know. And if you want some more guidance and support in your healthy lifestyle, visit disableyourdisability.com. Join the Fit for Life Academy while you're there. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And until next time, remember to eat right, get moving, and get your mind straight. Because with those three things working together, you can and will live the healthy, high-powered, happy life you deserve. Peace.